Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hey everyone, welcome to a holiday cube draft. We have got a few cards in here that are somewhat interesting, and then a lot of boring cards. So the first one, we have Metalworker. There are a ton of artifacts in this version of the cube, and so Metalworker can definitely power out some nasty creatures. Even Emrakul, for example. There's also Cryptic Command, Emrakul, Eternal Witness, and that's about it. There's Rishadan Port and Birthing Pod also. I've never actually had a good Birthing Pod deck, though. They're kind of difficult to make. Although, starting with one first, you get a little bit of value. Although, I'd probably want to start with Eternal Witness and then get Pod from there. Who knows? But I think I'm going to start with Cryptic Command. It's generally pretty sweet. And while it's not nearly as broken as a lot of the other cards, it's certainly one of my more favorite. Now looking at this pack, we've got some more boring stuff. There's actually a Verdant Catacombs, which is pretty good. Both Faithless Looting and Looter Ilkor are nice in a reanimator deck. There's Mirror Battlesphere, and that's about it in terms of exciting cards. Mana Tithe is okay, Green Sun's Nymph can be okay, but I'm going to stick with the Battlesphere, because it certainly puts out a lot of things into play. And we'll end up using it for most of our decks. Well, there's an Unburial Rites. There's also an Azorius Signet and a Simic Signet. Dungeon Geists. Well, tons of Geists. Geist galore. Geist for days and days, literally. I think I want to go ahead and take this Azorius Signet. I'm a pretty big fan of Signets, and Azorius being my guild means that I'm somewhat partial to them, so we're going to have to go with that. We could always take this Unburial Rites and try and go to Reanimator. And there's that Looter of Core and the Faithless Looting from earlier. So I could definitely see doing something like this. Although I'd rather start off with the Azorius Signet and sort of try and wheel this. Ooh, wow. I think blue might be open. Got Counterspell, Opposition, Fencer, and to a lesser extent, Gifts and Given. Gifts and Given is certainly a nice setup card, especially when you're playing with Unburial Rites and all that nonsense, Faithless Looting. There's also a Noble Hierarch and a Koth. There's just a ton of good cards in here. If this were a normal cube pack, I would really have to question what people to our right had taken, but seeing as this is a powered cube, there certainly are cards that I would immediately take over any of these. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take Opposition. I do like Counterspell and Venser, but Opposition lets you do a lot of cool stuff. Especially with cards like Mirror Battlesphere. Man, can you imagine that? You just get so many guys. And this pack is decidedly less exciting. There's a Sword of Fire and Ice, which can be pretty sweet. There's also some red cards. Now, I would love to take Hallowed Fountain, but there's the sword here, and we do have the opposition, so I kind of want to play a deck that has creatures in it, and a deck with creatures is probably good with Sword of Fire and Ice. So, as much as I want to take this, and I really do, I think the sword is actually going to be the pick for us this time. And this pack, we have a Nantuka Vigilante, we have a Mirari's Way, Carpenter Spring, Shrine of Burning Rage, Stomping Grounds. Not really sure where we want to go with this. It looks like red's probably open. I don't think white is open at all, so this Azorius Signet is probably just going to be a single color, just a blue for us. And I really like Nantuka Vigilante a lot in this version, just because like I said earlier, the number of artifacts has increased, so he gets a lot better. Wow. Here's some stuff. There's All Is Dust. Probably can take a Phyrexian Revoker. Natural Order could be okay. Natural Order means we're probably going to be pretty heavy green, though. And I don't really like that with Cryptic Command. But it's not really evident that blue is open. Besides that pack that we had earlier with four blue cards, we haven't really seen too much otherwise. So it's a little bit troublesome. So I think what I want to do is just take the Phyrexian Revoker. Generally, it can be okay. I tend to play against Phyrexian Revoker a lot, and so I want to try playing with Phyrexian Revoker to see how it is. Now here we have either Xenagos, or we can take a blue card. There's also Simic Pie Swallower. but actually, I like the way Xenagos plays out in terms of just making creatures for opposition. Wake Thresher is decent, but I like how Xenagos really fuels this the equipment and opposition that we have. I think here we can just take an Indrik Stomp Howler. There is an Overrun Tomb also, but black does not seem open at all, so I don't want to take that. We could take a Boros Signet, but I kind of like the Stomp Howler here. And I think we can actually take Temple Garden. That'll be pretty good with fetch lands and all that. So if we end up getting off fetch land, that's both like a Flooded Strand, for example. And we're playing blue and green. The green side can get Temple Garden, and the blue side can get Island. So it'll end up being a Tropical Island, which is effectively what we're searching for. And then I suppose we can just take Primal Command here. It seems like blue is maybe not necessarily open, which kind of sucks, because there was a one pack earlier. Huntmaster of the Fells or Llanowar Wastes? Well, we're playing with Xenagos. I kind of like Huntmaster, so we'll try that. And I guess we can take an Overrun Viper. So, I mean, there is green-red stuff. Kill the Marauders, Price of Progress. I definitely like playing with non-basic lands and all those dust wheels, which is sort of cute. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem like we are going to have too much blue, which is going to make playing Cryptic Command worse, and I certainly wish I had the Simic Signet now. That's still the Azorius Signet, because white was not apparently open at all. And this pack is also quite mediocre. We've got a bunch of blue cards. Not really sure. There's no power. There's Everflowing Chalice, which I'll probably end up taking. I mean, there's Master of the Wild Hunt, which, again, good with sword, good with opposition. It's kind of underpowered, though, and I would prefer to take something that's a little more busty. But at this point, it's hard to say that what we are going to be playing with, in addition to green, is going to be blue. So I don't know how realistic it is to load up on a bunch of double blue cards. But if blue is open, then, I mean, these cards are all okay, but I'd rather just take the Master here. I mean, the best cards in the pack are Gideon and Sun Titan. And I'm just basically all white, so I'm just going to take the Master. Wow. Jeez. This is something. Got Grimmonolith. Upheaval, Tundra, a lot of cards. I'm probably going to go with the Grim Monolith here. It's so much acceleration, and it's just quite powerful. I really wish that I could take, well, Upheaval, in the sense that with a lot of mana acceleration, Upheaval gets a lot better. But I'm just going to go ahead. Grim Monolith is just too good to pass. And then we get to this pack, which is just exact opposite. There's no blue cards. The only green card is Vengevine. I mean, Wild McCuddle is not a card in this deck. Let's take a look at quick cost sort. Take a quick look at red. I can take Winter Orb. That's certainly good with opposition. And yeah, I kind of like that, actually. Winter Orb might actually be good. Or I could just take Vengevine. Yeah, I think I'm going to just go with the Winter Orb. pains me to take that, but we might actually do it. And the thing with Winter Orb is, it's actually pretty sweet. Ooh, Tezzeret, Sundering Titan, Merman, Terminus. Kind of want to take the Sundering Titan, just blow up all the lands. Tezzeret certainly is a good card, though. Although this deck is going to have a little bit of difficulty casting it right now. And Plowunder is fine, but I like Sundering Titan a little bit more. I prefer to destroy lands rather than putting them on top. And here we could probably take Tolarian Academy. Cord is basically getting not too much. Call of the Herd is pretty dorky. There is Mystical Tutor, Daxos. But I prefer the Academy just because we've got so many artifacts. Well, not too many. We've got Revoker, Winter Orb, Sword. Yeah, we'll probably be able to pick up a few. And here I'm just going to take Moldrifter. Beast Within is fine, but I like drawing cards, and Moldrifter certainly draws quite a few. Wow. Everflowing Chalice, I wish I had that. I think we're going to go ahead and take this Sensei's top. I do like Awakening Zone. And there's Awakening Zone for opposition. That's close. There's also Cradle. Don't have too many creatures. Yeah, I think this is kind of close. I'm just going to go ahead and take the Awakening Zone. It's better with those two good cards that we have. And Ancient Grudges, always pretty sweet. And Grand Arbiter didn't really reduce the cost of our creatures, so just go ahead and take Ancient Grudge to splash. So this is certainly an interesting deck. And our original pack wield. There's Aeon Chronicler, Pristine Talisman, and I think I'm going to stick with Pristine Talisman. More artifacts for ramping up to this and powering up Academy. So, let's see. It's an August. It's only red and green mana, right? Yeah. Smash Smithereens, Eureka. Any permanent? Well, this can certainly be good. I kind of like playing this. There's also the Sylvan Library. I can draw a lot of cards. That's kind of close. I'm going to go with the Sylvan. And both the green cards wield, surprise. Well, like the points, both of those cards added up don't even equal one green card. Vengevine is, I guess, technically a card, but it's not that great. And here we're just going to take the Simic Signet. Don't really want to play with Plowunder. I'd rather play with Is It Signet because it fixes our mana for those two cards and powers this up. And we're going to need some help with our blue mana. And we actually don't have too many blue cards. But that's okay. The blue cards we have are good. Sure, Obstinate Beloth joins the fray. So yeah, we've got a bunch of 4-drops and Winter Orb for our nice deck. No 1-drops to accelerate. But I prefer having, in this deck, I prefer having the 2-drop artifacts. 1, 2, 3 are of them, plus Pristine Talisman. So, this deck is kind of weird. And get the Gaea's Cradle Academy deck sort of rounds that description out quite